springtime during my senior year of high school, which meant it was baseball season. The season was going along well, and I was having a great time playing baseball with my teammates. About halfway through the season, something tragic happened that changed my life. Uncle Joe had been hospitalized, and things were not looking good. He had been battling leukemia for quite some time, but I knew this trip to the hospital was no ordinary one. The day my uncle was admitted to the hospital happened to be the same day my team had its biggest game of the year versus our cross-town rival. Being team captain, I felt the responsibility to lead my team to victory. However, throughout the entire game, all I could think about was my uncle. Every time I glanced over to the fans and realized that he wasn't standing there, I started to tear up. I went on to play one of the worst games I ever played just because my head was not in the game. A few days later, my Uncle Joe passed away, and the whole process was very tough for me. The day after his funeral, I had another game to play. However, I did not know if I was going to play in it, because I didn't want to have another game like my last one. I ultimately decided that I was going to play in memory of my Uncle Joe, because I knew if he were there, he would have wanted me to play. Looking back on this particular moment in my life, it makes me think of the Last Supper Jesus shared with his disciples before he was crucified. In Luke chapter 22, verse 19, while preparing the Holy Sacrament, Jesus says, "Do this in remembrance of me." I know that my Uncle Joe would have requested that I play my game in remembrance of him, and that's what I did. Before every at-bat in that game, I looked up and I felt my uncle standing there to play with me. During that game, I had 3 hits, including a home run. It turned out to be one of the best games I have ever played.